New this morning, the White House is announcing details of the new $700 million package of security assistance to Ukraine. President Biden explained much more of this in a new op-ed this morning in the New York Times that reads in part, quote, "We have moved quickly to send Ukraine a significant amount of weaponry and ammunition so it can fight on the battlefield and be in the strongest possible position at the negotiating table. That's why I've decided that we will provide the Ukrainians with more advanced rocket systems and munitions that will enable them to more precisely strike key targets on the battlefield in Ukraine." CNN was the first to report that the U.S. would provide these weapons. Our Natasha Bertrand joins us. Natasha, so what more does this package mean? I thought it was interesting that the Biden op-ed was sort of titled, "What the U.S. Will Do and Won't Do When It Comes to Ukraine."
Yeah, Poppy, so they're really trying to strike this balance here between providing Ukraine the equipment that it needs to fend off the Russians, but also prevent Russia from feeling provoked and like it will retaliate against the West. So what the president said in that op-ed was that he is going to be sending these advanced rocket systems, which will, according to senior administration officials who spoke to reporters last night, be able to launch munitions about 80 kilometers or about 49 miles. And that is far greater range than anything the U.S. has sent to date. And that is why the Russians have been angry about the possibility that the U.S. is going to be sending this equipment. They have called it a red line. The Kremlin spokesman this morning said that it was adding fuel to the fire of the conflict. But in addition to this, to these rocket systems, of course, the U.S. is going to continue to send other equipment that it has been sending already, including Javelin anti-tank missiles, including helicopters, tactical vehicles, and spare parts, so that the Ukrainians can actually maintain the equipment that the United States and the West is sending to them. Now, the Kremlin, as I said, is not reacting particularly well this morning to the Biden administration's announcement. They say that the U.S. is only seeking to prolong the conflict and that they are doing so purposefully. But the White House is pushing back on that. And this morning, the Deputy National Security Advisor, John Feiner, he said that the U.S. does not negotiate its packages, its weapons packages, with the Kremlin, and that essentially the U.S. won't be bullied out of providing Ukraine with the equipment that it needs. Take a listen.
"We don't negotiate our security assistance packages to Ukraine well with the Kremlin. They have not been pleased by the amount of security assistance we've been providing to the Ukrainians, frankly, since far before this most recent phase of the conflict began. But I will also say that President Biden warned President Putin directly, and we said so publicly as well, that if Russia launched a renewed invasion of Ukraine, the United States would increase the amount of security assistance we were providing, including new and advanced systems."
So importantly, Poppy, Biden also noted in his op-ed that the United States, while, of course, detesting Vladimir Putin's behavior and his rule, is not seeking his ouster. So again, an attempt to reassure the Russians here that the U.S. is not going to get directly engaged in this conflict by getting in conflict with Russian forces.
Natasha Bertrand, thanks so much for the reporting.
Joining me now for more on this is CNN military analyst, retired General Wesley Clark. He's a former NATO Supreme Allied Commander. It's good to see you, General. First and foremost, can you talk to me about these advanced rocket systems? What can they do and what are their limitations for Ukraine?
Well, they're going to extend the battle space for Ukraine so Ukraine can hit deeper Russian targets inside Ukraine. Also, so that these systems can be moved further out of range of Russian artillery. So this is very important. The Ukrainian artillery is still outnumbered more than 2-1 by the Russian artillery. And they're fighting a desperate battle to hold on to Donbas. And it's an artillery battle. So these systems will provide crucial ability to strike accurately against Russian artillery, keep it off the Ukrainian troops, and enable Ukraine to hang on and maybe even regain some of its territory in eastern Ukraine.
You heard the Secretary of State saying there that it's in echoing what the president had said in announcing this, is one key to this agreement, it appears, was getting assurances from Ukraine that Ukraine wouldn't be using this to fire into Russia, into Russian territory. What do you think of those assurances?
Well, I think they're good assurances, and I think they're appropriate in this case because, as the president has said, we are not trying to start a war with Russia. They're making a lot of irresponsible threats to the West, but the United States and NATO are not responding to that. But what we are determined to do is to help Ukraine defend its own territory, maintain its territorial integrity, and be politically independent. That's our obligation under the United Nations Charter, and that's the obligation that the United States is fulfilling.
The Russian spokesman, though, responded already to this announcement, probably not surprisingly. And the way the Kremlin spokesperson put it was that the U.S. is purposefully and diligently adding fuel to the fire. And this is one thing that President Biden kind of clearly wanted to address in his opinion piece announcing these new weapons, because he was, what they're very clearly trying to say is they're not trying to, as you're talking about, provoke Russia. Let me read what he wrote in part in this opinion piece. "We do not seek a war between NATO and Russia. As much as I disagree with Mr. Putin and find his actions an outrage, the United States will not try to bring about his ouster in Moscow." Do you think these new weapon systems heading into Ukraine, do you think this has a chance of provoking Russia further?
Absolutely not. But it's certainly going to be used by Russia in the information war to blame the United States. And there's nothing new about this. I mean, they've blamed the United States from the beginning. The target for the information war is Europe and the European public opinion. But the United States has to lead NATO. It has to have a strong response. And our NATO allies have to come on board and follow the United States lead in this. And this helps them deal with their own public. There's a battle going on for European public opinion. It happens every time with Russia. But the president's showing the right kind of leadership in holding NATO together and in supporting Ukraine.
General, I have heard some suggest that they believe that these weapons heading over now is too little too late at this point in the conflict. What do you think about that?
I think it would have been better if we'd had them like a month ago, 6 weeks ago. I've been saying on CNN for the last 6 or 8 weeks that we're entering this critical time. But honestly, the Ukrainians have done a much better job of holding in Donbass than we could have imagined. Trouble, Kate, is they've taken very heavy losses there. How heavy? We don't know, but substantial. You can't stay under that pounding of Russian artillery, even if you have your own artillery shooting back, and not expect to take losses. So these weapons and the other American reinforcement of artillery is absolutely necessary. I wish we could have gotten it there sooner, and we have to get this there as soon as possible. But, you know, one of the things that's held the Biden administration back, of course, is NATO leadership. And we have to coordinate with our allies on every one of these steps. And the real strength of this is NATO. So 4 HIMARS systems getting there, really important, need them right away, but not more important than NATO consensus and the support of our allies and understanding of our allies and what we're doing. So I think the administration has done as much as it could reasonably do at this point, thinking about all the other constraints. Now the question is, how quickly can we get them there? And will we follow up the initial 4 with more? Because we need to keep Ukraine in this fight. They want to regain their territory. And as the president said, there's going to be no pressure from us on Ukraine to negotiate and give away ground. Ukraine's going to go as far as it can go, and hopefully we're there supporting them. They're democratic. They want to be aligned with us. They're fighting NATO's battle. This is really important for the United States.
It's good to see you, General. Thank you very much.